What's up, guys? Today's junk is a tour of my mechanic service cart. Now, few people have seen this in previous videos and asked me to do a tour on this service cart, but full disclosure, I am not a mechanic. I am simply a DIY guy that does all his own auto mechanics and home maintenance and stuff like that. And I found it to be very frustrating to work on a vehicle out in the street and constantly walk back and forth from the garage to get one tool that I needed to do something very, very specific. And I don't have enough room in the garage to pull the vehicle up, and my project truck is actually in the driveway. So any work I do on any other vehicle, it's gonna be out in the street. So I need to have tools readily available for that. And I decided to reuse my Harbor Freight tool cart that I've had for a number of years at this point, and it was kind of just sitting in the garage, not being used. I didn't have a purpose for it until I had the bright idea to actually bring it back and use it for its designed purpose, a rolling tool cart. So I took all my most commonly used tools and I put them in the tool cart, thinking about priorities and thinking about what tools would need to be accessible quickly in order to get the job done most efficiently. So a lot of mechanics do this kind of thing, and it seems to speed up efficiency and productivity. So I'm going to take it outside where there's better lighting, and I'll give you a quick tour of the tools that I have organized the way I do in this tool cart. So here's the cart. Again, Harbor Freight tool cart. The badge fell off at one point and I had this extra Craftsman badge. I just put it on there to keep that spot protected. Whatever. There were a couple of holes there and they just snapped right in. All right, so you will see a variety of brands here that may or may not be considered professional grade. I am not a professional mechanic, as mentioned, and I have stuff on this cart that works for me. So you're going to see some Ryobi tools. You're going to see some other brands that may or may not, again, be considered professional. So this is just what I have on the cart that works for me, not being a professional mechanic. I think you get the point. So anyway, I wouldn't have anything on this cart that doesn't work. Let's just put it that way. I know it works for me, that's why I have it on the cart. Anyway, starting up at the top, you got your gloves, paper towels, magnetic dish. On this side, I have my two magnets, BB blaster, and then underneath, we'll start left to right, I have all my oil change wrenches and things like that. This is my oil change toolkit. Everything I might need to get that done for a variety of vehicles. I have a half inch impact wrench made by Ryobi. This thing, for the price, kicks butt. It actually does a really good job. There's never been a time where I have had to do anything that this wouldn't do it. And if it didn't, I just get a breaker bar and do what I gotta do. This thing in the back, I forget what it's actually called, but this is the Ryobi like multi-tool, something like that. The head comes off and it's got a ratchet head. This has seen better days. And eventually I'm gonna upgrade to the Milwaukee M12 ratchet because I have some M12 tools and batteries, and that would just be a nice addition. So I'm not doing that until that thing dies. Then I have the DeWalt drill with some drill bits and some other things in this bag. And I have the DeWalt impact driver with bits and things like that. So I keep them separate. Being a DIY guy, I have to have these things readily available for interior homework, home improvement work as well. So I keep this whole cart right on the inside of the garage. I know exactly where my drill is. I know exactly where my impact driver is. All bits and drill bits and everything are right here. I come in, I grab both bags, I take it in the house, hang a picture frame or something up for my wife, good to go. Okay, so I keep all that organized that way. Now let's prop up the camera on the tripod and go on the inside. This is the top portion here. Once you lift up the lid, we'll go left to right. I have my Torx drivers here, 10, 15, 20, 25. I should have a 27 floating around somewhere in the garage, and you'll see that kind of thing happens a lot with me where I'm missing a couple of sockets. They're either in the garage or the vehicle or whatever. They're around. I just got to put them back once I find them. I have battery cleaning tools here. So if I do battery changes or just general tune-ups on any of my family's vehicles, make sure I check the battery. I have half inch, 3/8 and 1/4 inch drive sockets, both metric and standard. Just a hodgepodge collection of things that I've acquired throughout the years, and I kind of need to make sure I fill in the gaps. So if I am missing a 3/4 inch, 1/2 inch drive, I need to either find that or buy a new one. That's actually a pretty common size. Up top here, I have my Torx. I have hex, both metric and standard. Spark plug sockets, And then more spark plug sockets here with the swivel. I'm actually, again, missing one. There should be a third round here somewhere. I have a variety of socket wrenches here. I really do, this is gonna sound weird, but I like these Harbor Freight coated one. I guess they got this rubber coating. I guess that's what it would be called. But this is good in colder weather, which is what we're experiencing right now, as well as when you're doing anything with battery terminals. It will not bridge the connection between the two terminals arcing. So I try to use something like this when I'm doing anything battery or when it's cold. I do have a bunch of other socket wrenches that kind of come in and out of this drawer depending on what I'm doing that day. And I keep most of them inside. These are the ones I need for that day. Over here I have an OBD2 reader, no big deal, just, you know, homeowner grade, whatever. My job basically is just to get the code to figure out what the story is and then fix it from there. Then over here I have my screwdrivers, some Phillips, some flatheads, whatever. Let's go down to the next drawers. Next level down, I have two drawers. On the right, I have all my pliers I could need. I really like these Husky mini pliers. I came in a set, I got them in clearance, and I use these all the time. These are really good. I have, just for the price, you can't beat them. I'm sure there's better quality, but these guys do the job perfect. A couple of adjustable wrenches. I have a exhaust hanger plier set, and I recently just used this on my truck build that I'm working on. These are hose pliers to get hoses apart. These work really well. I forget where I got these from, but they're probably like a no-name brand. Yeah, I don't see anything on here. So these guys work pretty well. Vice grips, channel locks, cutters and needle nose and so on. And Husky, I also got this set of needle nose, angled and straight. These guys work really well. I need to get a set of the longer ones that have the double joint. Right? You've seen them before. I need to get a set of those and just add it to this collection. But you can never really have enough pliers. You always got to be grabbing stuff. Now on this other side here on the left, I have my Craftsman re-threader kit. This thing has gotten me out of a couple of jams and I really like this kit. And as some of these parts start to get worn out, I'll just replace them individually. But once you get this kit, it's really going to save you a lot of trouble, because you can clean up bolts and threads before you reinstall them, potentially avoiding stripping them out. And this is just a thread gauge here. I don't recall if this came with it or not. I don't think it did, because this says made in Germany. So I might have just thrown this in here to kind of complement the rest of this kit. But this kit I got a bunch of years ago. It was $60-$75, somewhere in that ballpark. And I use it all the time. If I'm gonna be reusing a threaded fastener of any kind, I always try and clean it up with something like that before I get to it. And then speaking of re-threaders, spark plug re-threader, that needs to be cleaned up itself. Then I got a nut buster, stud remover, a couple of picks, feeler gauges, spark plug gappers, a little mirror, you get the idea. This thing here is another thing that's gotten me out of a couple of jams. This is a fastener or rounded off fastener remover. So if you have a fastener whose head's a little chewed up, something like this will get you to help at least try and get that out. So that's my second level drawers. Let's go down to the third. Next drawer down is the swivels and extensions and wobbles for the socket set that I have up top. So I have them in these bread pans that I got from, I think it was the dollar store or something. At first they didn't fit all that well with what else I had going on, because these three were originally in another toolbox. So I had to bend the ends down. No big deal. It's not pretty, but it works out great. And just being really cheap, I didn't feel too bad about doing that. And I just have them all piled up in here. So half inch, 3/8, quarter inch. And with the quarter inch, I also have, you know, driver, you know, flexible extension, and you get the idea. This thing is pretty cool. It's a driver with a flexible extension. I don't even remember where I got half this stuff, but I've acquired them over the years, and you know, they get used when they need to be used. Then over here on the left, I have you know, my fluids, carb, brake, mass airflow, and throttle body, that just cleaners, whatever, okay? Stuff that you might need at any moment. And I have more in the garage that I can restock this as I need to. A couple of pry bars, breaker bar, breaker bar, and then the longer extensions that wouldn't fit in the bread loaf pan, so I just stick them here. And yeah, all right, next drawer. Last drawer wrench and hammer drawer. So these are the most commonly used wrenches that I have, that I keep and I use for most jobs. So I got the ratcheting set. This is on this side is Imperial or standard, and this is metric over here on the right. So I got the gear wrench, ratcheting, and then SK wrenches that are non-ratcheting. Then I got these little guys. These are gear wrench, right? This is good for like short little stuff. A couple of hammers, sledgehammer and rubber mallet. And then same deal over here with your metric. So these happen to be the Craftsman copy or whatever equivalents of the standards that I have. These are metric though. And then I got the SK wrenches. I really like SK wrenches. For the price, they really can't be beat. As far as I'm concerned, they're professional grade, if not just a hair under, and the price is a fraction of the cost of something like Snap-on. So that's that. Let's go back inside and close this video up. All right, so that's that. That's the cart that I use to do any mechanical work. There are other versions of this cart, and you don't necessarily need all these drawers. To be honest with you, I'm thinking about picking up a second cart that I can use as a tray for parts. Now I'm finding not only do I have all my tools readily available, I just wheel this out to the car, but I need a spot to put the parts that I take off while doing repairs. So something like an adjustable height tray would be very, very useful, or just one of those Harbor Freight cheapo carts that have no drawers, and then I can just put it on there and then use that as like an assembly table as well. I am a DIY guy. I don't know if I mentioned that, but I'm not a mechanic. Being a DIY guy with an overstuffed garage from too many projects and equipment from my landscaping business, I need to have things mobile that I can just wheel outside when I'm using them. So that something like that would be my next tool upgrade. And they could be had pretty cheap as far as I'm concerned. So that might be in my near future. Someplace on wheels that I can put parts on as I'm working on the vehicle. So I can have my tool cart, and you know, kind of sandwich myself at the hood, tool cart and parts cart right there, and I just make sure I get muscle memory. Always put the tool cart on one side, whether it's your right or left. These are efficiency things that I'm picking up along the way. Again, not a professional mechanic. Don't know if I mentioned that, but if you guys are professional mechanics, I'm sure you've come across these ideas all along during your training and experience. I have just experience. And very little of it, to be honest with you. So this seems to be working out for me. Tool brands aside, whatever, the types of tools I have on my cart are tools that I need for my type of work that I do. And if you're a DIY guy, something like this will speed up your productivity immensely, especially if you got to walk back and forth from your main toolbox to the vehicle or project you're working on. This is light enough that I can wheel it all the way around the block if I had to. I never will, but if I had to work on a neighbor's vehicle or something. Just the other day, I'm working on my stepdaughter's car, and that's not exactly right outside. It's actually a couple car spots up from the garage and the driveway. So I just wheel it up there, pop the hood, get to work. And I have 90% of what I need. If I need like an oddball thing, say I'm doing like brake work or something, knowing that ahead of time, I can pull out my brake tools and add it to the cart for that day. And if I have the second parts cart, it just makes that easier. You know, I could probably do both at the same time. Well, I hope you guys get where I'm coming from with this video and understand that I am not a professional mechanic. So with that, I hope you liked this video. And if you did, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. As always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Getting Junk Done. I have an edited video, which is what you're watching now, every Thursday about 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and a live stream every Sunday night about 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thanks for watching.